Hi guys. I want to do it myself, but I can't. You know you're actually distracting me. Hi guys. I'm not talking right now. Why am I not talking? Dog. Why am I not talking? Stay up. Stay up, phone. Hi guys, it's Eden. I'm going to read The Duck in the Hole. 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 Keisha heard a quack. Keisha heard a quack. Keisha heard a quack. A quack. She looked around the yard. Quack. The sound was coming from the hole in the ground. I'm trying to let you see the hole, but you can just see Keisha. You can just see Keisha if you want. There's a picture of Keisha. Now I get to read. Keisha ran to the hole. She looked in. She was surprised to find a little brown duck at the bottom. Quack, quack, it cried. Let me see what's there. It's a little plant with ladybug on its leaf. It's grass and stones and a ladybug. The duck looked scared. The hole was narrow and deep. The little duck couldn't jump or fly out. You poor thing, how did you get in down there? Keisha asked. Don't worry, I'll get you out. There's the little duck in the hole. There's the little duck. And there is Keisha. Tries to find the little duck. I'd be surprised to find the duck. Keisha got down on her hands and knees. She reached into the hole, but couldn't get the duck. Her arms were too short. Quack, quack, the little duck cried again. Look, there is some flower. There's a flower bush with a fence, and there's Keisha reaching down, getting her, trying to get the duck. Flower fence, and Keisha. Keisha thought, she thought about putting a rope down the hole. Then she remembered that ducks had wings, not hands. They couldn't climb ropes. And then the duck is like, huh? What if she tried a basket to the end of the rope? The duck could jump into the basket, and Keisha could pull it out. Keisha looked at the hole. No, that wouldn't work. The hole wasn't big enough. There wasn't room in there for both the duck and the basket. Let's go show you this. There's the duck in the basket. Maybe she could get a shovel and make the hole bigger, dig it out. Dig it out a little. No, she better not. No matter how how careful she was. Rocks and dirt would fall into the hole. They might hurt the duck. It might hurt. They might hit the duck and hurt it. The duck getting hit by the rocks, and Keisha shoveling the duck out. The machine they use to clean the rugs, so they're saying a vacuum, had a big long hose. Maybe Keisha could use it to suck the duck out of the hole. No, that was a bad idea. It might pull the duck's feathers out. Then it couldn't fly. Poor duck. Vacuum. Then her trying to pull the duck. Her mother and father would know what to do. Keisha was going to look for them. She saw the neighbor's cat. It had heard the quacking too. It was walking toward the hole. "Go home, Tiger," she yelled. It said, "Go home, Tiger," she yelled. What should she do? Poor little kid. It wants to eat the bird. Woof, woof. Keisha turned to look. Red, the dog from up the street, was running toward her. "Oh no," Keisha said, "not you too." And she's mad at the dog. Red ran to the hole and looked in. He wagged his tail and barked, "Quack, quack, quack." The duck cried in fear. Words. The dog trying to eat him. Keisha jumped up and down and waved her arms around. "Get out of here," she yelled. The dog ran out of the yard, so did the cat, but they didn't go far. They sat on the sidewalk and watched Keisha. So there is her jumping up and down and waving her arms. Then there is them sitting on the sidewalk. Keisha thought and thought and thought some more. Then she got an idea, a great idea. Keisha ran to get the garden hose. It was